Welcome to Target Tips and Tricks Christmas Edition, December 12th. Today, we're going to look into color engage agents, especially inside cross tabs, with some little bit advanced scenarios. Let's go and have a look. Here's a classic Target cross tab with a benchmark using dynamic time to set up year to date versus previous year to date, and a target calculation doing a growth percentage. So I'd like to have some help in identifying the negative growths here. So I'll go to the left-hand side to the properties and to the color engage agents to create a few agents to monitor this data here. Let's pick a default one. Default doesn't mean that you count out the other ones. You can do it later in the process if you want one of those types. So I'll just start out here. We're going to monitor growth percent, and we're going to set up a condition. So first of all, let's try and look at all the green ones, all the positive growth. We could set up a condition saying if the value is greater than zero, but I prefer actually to have this simple one saying all values is mentioned here, and we'll just add a color to this, and that will be the green color, and we'll say okay. So currently everything is green. Then we're going to do a copy of this agent we already made, duplicate, and we're going to say, okay, but if the value is less than zero, we're going to associate a color with that, which will be the color, not green, of course, but red. So what we're utilizing here is that these agents are read in sequence. So the last one will be the one that decides. So first, everything is green, and then the negative ones are red. So we sort of solved the problem, but I think there are three problems with these agents here. First problem, they are so far away from the number that they are monitoring. They should be on the other side of the number. Second problem, the shape doesn't tell the story, only the color, and to the red and green colorblind, this will leave them in the dark, sort of. Third problem, or something that's up for discussion, is do we really need to color some red and then all the others green? Couldn't we just have the red ones and then it would sort of be obvious that then that the rest of them are okay? So all three problems, let's try and have a look at them. First, let's look at the green agent and make it sort of disappear. And I'm going to open up the green one here. We'll stick with the condition. For the action, we're going to say we want an icon, and we want it to be on the right side of the number, right justified. Now, we're going to pick a gauge, and there's a lot of different series of gauges here, but I particularly like these arrows because they have this one. Well, this is actually a transparent symbol. So if I use this and click OK, what happens is that I actually move all those numbers a little bit because there's actually a transparent piece of graphics down here. And that means now we can fix the others and go and say, again, this should be an icon. This should be right justified. It should probably be an arrow down, not the transparent one, but one down. And it should keep the color red. So notice everything is justified the same way because we have the transparent symbol and the symbol is much closer to the number and the shape of the symbol is an arrow pointing down signifying that this is negative. Well, we didn't leave the colorblinds in the dark in this case. Here's another example showing the absence numbers for a group of employees throughout each day of the month. So if you drill through this slicer on the left-hand side, you can learn a little bit about the absence numbers for these employees. Some of them have some registrations here and there where they've been absent, but it's very, very hard to understand the pattern of these data when you look at the numbers here and discover if there's something different than a zero somewhere in the table. So let's try and make these numbers speak in a little bit different way. Let's go into edit mode and select this table. And now we're going to make color agents that actually hides the numbers because I'm not interested in the numbers. I'm interested in the pattern. So I'm going to color engage agents and say default. And I'll just stick with this condition saying everything. Then we're going to the action tab. And now we're going to color the cell background as a progress bar. And we're going to right justify this progress bar. So it's going to color it from right to left. I prefer that. On the gauge, we can skip that because we're just going to color the cell background. So I'm going to the color choice. And on the color choice, I'm going to choose the color, not green, but instead red. Because absence is, well, in some ways not a good thing. Notice there's a lot of zeros here. So what will happen when I click OK here? Well, actually, this wasn't quite what I pictured because the zero registrations are also colored. And also, I was planning on leaving out the numbers. So let's go back and fix the agent up so it does exactly what I want it to. Two things. First, on the action tab, we're going to choose hide cell text. That will take away the numbers and just leave the graphics. And secondly, a little nice tip here. Currently, the scale that it colors these cells is automatically calculated. But I'd like to interfere a little bit and set a minimum to 1. That means that the cells holding zeros will be left out because the scale actually begins at 1. Let's just say OK. So now we have something different. Now we can actually drill through those different employees and learn a little bit about their pattern of absence in a more storytelling manner than we before when we just had the numbers. That concludes today's tips and tricks Christmas edition. See you tomorrow for another tip.